Hi everyone, welcome to AWS training program. So going forward in the AWS training program, today we'll be talking about few more services on AWS. So these services are SNS, which stands for Simple Notification Service, SES, that is Simple Email Service, SQS, Simple Queue Service, and the last but not the least is SWF, Simple Workflow Service. These services are like helper services or small services which works with other AWS services. They may not have the standalone existence, but they can be integrated with other services. So we'll be starting the class with the agenda. So the agenda for today's class is overview of SNS, overview of SES, overview of SQS, overview of SWF. So let's get started with SNS. So as the name indicates, SNS is Simple Notification Service. If you want to notify someone, that can be application, that can be person, that can be email, that can be some chat messenger or any other application, it can be anything. So it is a fully managed messaging service for both application to application or application to person as well. For example, suppose my CloudWatch alarm is there. Let's talk about EC2 instance. If the CPU utilization of my EC2 instance is reaching beyond 85%, then it should notify something. So if I talk about application to application, there can be some lambda function. So if my alarm goes beyond threshold, it will notify the lambda that this is the situation. After that, the lambda can take the necessary action. Maybe Lambda will stop the EC2 instance, or Lambda can launch one more EC2 instance, or Lambda can change the type of EC2 instance, right? So basically one application is notifying another application regarding some changes, regarding some predefined conditions. Another example, application to person. That means if something goes wrong or something met the threshold, we want to get notified either over the email or some Slack channel, or there are a lot of variety of that. Even you can get SMS on your mobile phone. So that also we can configure, and accordingly we can receive the notification so that the concerned team can act upon time. Now the A2A functionality provides topic for M2M messaging between event driven application. M2M means many to many. That means you can send notification to many applications as well. It's not like one to one. That means if your alarm is reaching the threshold, you want to do multiple things. You want to send an email to a particular team that this CPU utilization is going beyond 85%. At the same time, you want to send some SMS to some concerned person. At the same time, you want to send this notification to a Lambda function so that it can do some action, right? So it is many to many. So we can create topics in SNS. Topic is nothing but a medium which connects both parties, sender and receiver. For example, suppose there's a newspaper, right? And you have subscribed to it. There's a magazine, you have subscribed to it, or it can be Netflix. You have subscribed for a monthly or yearly subscription, right? So many person has subscribed to that service. Whenever they release any new movie or any new series on Netflix, whoever are the subscriber, multiple, right? They will get the notification. Similarly, in SNS, we can create the topics. Your publisher can send message to a large number of subscriber like SQS, Lambda functions, HTTPS endpoints. These are nothing but different type of subscriber. I will show you practically like how to create a SNS topic and then how to add the different type of subscriber to it. So this was about like the topics and publisher. In simple words, we call it as publisher and subscriber. The application which will be sending the message or sending the event to the topic, that is publisher, and whoever are the subscriber, those can be person, those can be application, those can be email recipient, right? Those are the subscriber. And the A2P functionality enables you to send messages to users at scale via SMS, mobile push, and email. as I was telling you, right? If something is hitting some threshold, or there can be some other criteria, right? Suppose you are executing a job, and if the job is successful, you want to send an email to some particular set of recipients. But if the job fails, then there can be another group that can be support group. You want to notify them via email so that they can immediately look into that. And there can be other applications. I know one of the application is ServiceNow. ServiceNow is a support application. And what that does is they have configured something. They will say that you send an email with a particular format of subject, that the first keyword should be your environment name, dev, stage, or production. After that, colon. After that, you have to provide the severity. It's like medium or low or high. After that, the subject line of the your problem, right? Something like that. So as soon as you will send an email with that predefined subject format, ServiceNow will create a service ticket for you automatically. And as soon as the ticket will be created, it will be assigned to some person, right? And then they will start looking into that issue. So all these things can be integrated. So that's what I said. These applications, these services may not have their standalone existence, but they can be integrated with our services. They can be integrated with third party services, and they can help us to notify on time. So this is very brief overview about SNS. We will be doing this practically. I will show you. So any doubts till now, Fortune?
No, you don't need it. All these actually we are using, but it's just not cloud.
Okay, that's good. You use SNS topics?
We use SMS, and we also have email notifications.
No, but do you receive all these things via SNS?
Yeah, via SMS. Like, to all our business person, whenever job fails, they receive the SMS that the job failed.
No, not SMS. I'm talking about SNS. Are you receiving all these things with the simple notification service?
No, not with SNS. I'm saying the functionality. Mm-hmm. Like, whenever a job fails, they get the email notification, SMS notification, all that I'm saying.
Right. Okay, that's good. So let's go to the next slide. That would give you even more idea. You can see that. So as I said, it's many to many. There can be many applications which will be sending messages or events to SNS. And then SNS, there can be many subscribers. Lambda can be one of the subscribers. SQS is another service, but that can be a subscriber for SNS. Similarly, Amazon Kinesis, that is another AWS service which is used to analyze your data. Or there can be HTTPS, some website which can receive your data. And apart from that, as we said, like SMS, Slack notification, email notification, and all that stuff. On the left side, AWS Compute Service, EC2 instance, that can send some notification to the SNS topic. Storage service like S3, database service like RDS, Redshift, networking service, security group, subnet, VPC. Suppose there is someone is trying to hit your security group. Someone is trying to access your servers via some port, but that port is blocked. But you have configured that if someone tries to hit that port, first of all, you have to block that traffic. That's one thing. At the same time, you should notify someone so that we came to know that someone, unauthorized person, is trying to access our server. So we can do that. Or AWS developer tools, like we had Cloud9, or there can be some other thing, right? So there can be many more services which can be integrated with your SNS, and then SNS can send the notification to multiple AWS services.
So in this, does any service come default, or we have to pay extra for all the services we use?
No, we have to pay if we are using that.
Okay, nothing comes default. All these,
so default, like, in the sense that it's showing free.
Yeah, like free as in when we buy a basic AWS thing.
Yeah, for every service, there is some limit. Like if you are sending 100 messages a day, that is comes under your free limit. But after that, it would be charged, right? Something like this. Every service has some free quota.
Got it. For personal use, you can. For business, maybe you need, right?
Right. For training purpose, it's fine. Yeah. So this one, and then, okay. So next is how to create SNS topic. So instead of showing you on a screenshot, I will show you live, because screenshot you can later look at your free time. So let me open the AWS console. So I was checking my bills and all. It's always a good practice to keep checking your bills. Is something like, it's very less, $0.47, but still it's a good idea to check. So one day we executed some crawler jobs, and that was chargeable, which I was not aware, but anyway, I created for training purpose and I immediately deleted that, so that's fine. So we'll go to SNS, simple notification service. So there is already one topic created, I think, for taking a screenshot. I created that, but anyway, we can delete and recreate. Okay, so you go to SNS and then you can click on topics. You can even click on subscription. So I will delete this as well, because this is no longer required now. Okay, so I will go to topics, and since there is no topic available, I will create the topic. So you can create.